I've been playing disc golf for probably 4 years now. I started my sophomore year of high school. Actually saw a bunch of friends playing. I was like, what are you guys doing? And they're like, we're playing disc golf. And I was like, what is disc golf? When we first moved to Arizona, my dad and I had both bought like starter sets. So we both had 3 discs, I think. And I was like, I think I still have those. Do you mind if I play next time? And they're like, yeah, sure, you can come with us. And so I went out and played with them next time and did absolutely horrible.
Well, we moved to Fountain Hills where they had a course, and it was in this park in the center of town. And we had walked the park, saw the baskets, decided to give it a try. So we bought some starter kits and gave it a try.
And so when we go up to our cabin up in Sholo, about 2 hours away, it's all mountains and trees. And so the first time we played that course, we were hitting trees left and right, and it forces you to really learn how to bend discs, which was really cool for us to do because it was a different style of playing.
I thought it was fun. Our course is a very hard course because of the water. So I didn't really want to play a whole lot because I didn't want to lose discs and have to spend the money on discs.
We started throwing our starter sets more, which came with the Leopard. I've actually got 2 of those hanging up right behind me because it's still my favorite disc. But we got those down and we're like, oh, this is a lot easier.
The whole science behind the thing, there's a lot more to it than just throwing frisbees. And as we started to learn how to do it and get better, it really began to be fun. You know, we noticed ourselves getting better and just kept playing week in, week out.
And as you get into it more and more, you realize how many similarities there are with disc golf and golf, just with how many different disc speeds. So you realize how much form and arm speed goes into this game, because I've put my Leopard over 400 feet before. I've never broken 370 with this, which those are both great throws for me, but it just shows you how much goes into the game.
I think just trying out different courses and playing with a group of friends. We have a really good group of friends that I play with, most guys from my church. And part of it is just that. We have a great group and we just laugh a lot with each other, at each other. And we just enjoy good quality time together playing disc golf and learn how to play.
As you get into the sport, you just realize there's so much that goes into it. I mean, you've got your different courses, you've got different hole layouts, you've got different discs, different bags, towels, retrievers, all these things.
But I've loved the different courses. Jake and I always try, whenever we go on vacation, we try to play somewhere new. We played some pretty cool courses, one especially in Colorado. You had to hike 500 vertical feet to get to the tee box, and first hole teed off at 10,000 feet elevation, and you were just looking over this valley with a lake, Lake Dillon, in fact, in Colorado, and it was just so cool.
One of my favorite things with disc golf has been the community. I mean, the community is awesome. You go down to this course, and you see anyone playing, and it starts a conversation, and talk about scores, and tricks on holes, and discs you like, and it's this really cool thing, especially living where we live, where Paul McBeth and Ricky Wysocki, who are realistically the 2 top players in the world, a lot of them live in Arizona, and so I've seen a lot of these guys, I've met a few of them.
So we've just gotten to meet some really cool people as well, playing courses around the country, and see some pretty incredible things.